Namaste, students. We will be continuing with our chapter on market equilibrium. And in our previous class, we have been discussing about the shifts in the demand curve. What happens when there is a rightward shift of the demand curve or when there is a leftward shift of the demand curve? So it leads to situations of excess demand and excess supply. And then how again the equilibrium is reached, we have discussed that. Now moving on, we will be discussing the supply shifts. Okay, so when the supply curve shifts, but the demand curve remains the constant. So see, graphically if you see, you have quantity in the x-axis, price on the y-axis, and SS naught is your initial supply curve, DD naught is your initial demand curve, initial equilibrium is at point E. Now for some reason, suppose that the supply curve shifts to the left, that's it, there is a leftward shift of the supply curve. So what you find is that the new supply curve is SS2. Now with the initial, the demand remaining the same, the equilibrium quantity demanded is Q0, but with the new supply, the quantity supplied is how much? Q naught double dash, right? So what is happening is there is a situation of excess demand, that is quantity demanded is still here, OQ0, whereas the quantity supplied, new quantity supplied, is OQ naught double dash. So there is a situation of excess demand. Now when there is a situation of excess demand, some of the consumers are ready to pay more price in order to get the commodity which they are not getting because there is an excess demand. So what happens due to this excess demand, the now price increases. As the price increases, the quantity demanded keeps decreasing, whereas on the other side, the supply keeps on increasing, and ultimately the new equilibrium is at point G. And the new equilibrium price is P2, that is the increase in the price, and the new equilibrium output is OQ2. Clear? So this is when there is a leftward shift of the supply curve. Now similarly, see here, you find again the quantity in the x-axis and the price on the y-axis, and you have the demand, initial demand as DD naught, and your initial supply curve SS naught. So the E is the equilibrium point. So P naught, Q naught is the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity demanded. At this equilibrium price, there is a rightward shift of the supply curve to SS1. So what is happening? At the initial, that is equilibrium price, the quantity supplied is this much. The quantity demanded is OQ naught, but the quantity supplied is OQ naught dash. So there is a situation of excess supply. Now due to this excess supply, what will happen? Price will fall, and then as the price falls, the demand increases, and the demand increases, and ultimately the equilibrium is reached at point F. Okay, so quantity supplied by the firm decreases, price decreases, and then the quantity demanded by the consumer increases, and ultimately your equilibrium is at the point EF. So when there is an excess supply, we see that there is a fall in price, and when there is an excess demand, we see there is a rise in price. So this is basically the effect of the shifts of the supply curve. Now there can be simultaneous shifts of the demand and supply. So till now what we were keeping the supply constant, supply curve constant, and we were seeing the effects of the shifts in the demand curve. Next, what we have done, we have kept the demand curve constant, and we have seen the effect of the shifts of the supply curve. Now what we will do is, there will be a simultaneous shift of both the demand and the supply. So both demand and supply curve shifts to the right, or it can happen that both demand and supply curve shifts to the left, and so on. So again, we have taken a diagram. Quantity in the x-axis, price in the y-axis, the equilibrium D naught, H naught is given at E. Now suppose that the supply is shifted to the right, and the demand also shifts to the right. So what happens is that this is the equilibrium, and at that given price, now the new quantity intersection of the new demand curve and the new supply curve is at point F. So this becomes the new equilibrium point. So there is a increase in the output. So the demand curve intersect. Now in panel A, what we find, both supply and demand curve shifts rightward, leaving price unchanged. So since both the supply curve and the demand curve has changed, the price has remained unchanged, and the quantity supplied has increased. So price remains unchanged, but quantity gets increased. Clear? And in panel B, what we find due to the leftward shift of the demand curve. Here, it what finds the rightward, the supply curve shifts rightward, right? And the demand curve shifts leftward, and what ultimately what happens? The price decreases, leaving the quantity unchanged. So what is happening is that here what we are finding that the demand and supply are increasing in different directions. Supply is shifting in the rightward directions, whereas demand is increasing in the leftward direction. So the price falls. Why the price falls? Because supply has increased and demand has decreased. So the price will, there will be a situation of excess supply, so price will decrease and the quantity will remain the same, but price will decrease. So this is the situation of the simultaneous shifts of both the demand curve and the supply curve. So either both can shift to the rightward direction, or both can shift to the leftward direction, or that both can change in opposite direction. So supply curve shifting towards the right and demand curve shifting to the left, or it can happen that the supply curve shifts to the left and the demand curve shifts to the right. So this is the simultaneous shift of the supply and the demand curve. So what you will do is you will go through it, and then in our next class we will move forward with the next part of the chapter. Om Namah Shivaya.